மிஸ்டர் அமல்ராஜ் சேர்மன் பார் கவுன்சில், மிஸ்டர் கார்த்திகேயன் வைஸ் சேர்மன், மிஸ்டர் பிரபாகரன் மெம்பர் அண்ட் கோ சேர்மன் ஆஃப் த பார் கவுன்சில் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, எலெக்டட் மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பார் கவுன்சில், பிரதர் ஜட்ஜஸ் ஆன் த டைஸ் அண்ட் ஆஃப் த டைஸ், லேர்னட் அட்வொகேட் ஜென்ரல் மிஸ்டர் நடராஜ் பப்ளிக் ப்ராசிக்யூட்டர், ஆஃபீஸ் பேரர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி வேரியஸ் அசோசியேஷன் எம்பிஏ மெட்ராஸ் ஹைகோர்ட் அட்வொகேட்ஸ் அசோசியேஷன், மிஸ்டர் ஜவஹர்லால், மிஸ்டர் கார்வேந்தன் அண்ட் மிஸ்டர் ப்ரொஃபஸர் தனபால் அண்ட் அதர் டிக்னிட்டரிஸ் ஐ எம் நாட் ஏபிள் டு ரெக்கலெக்ட் நாட் ஏபிள் டு மென்ஷன் ஆல் தர் நேம்ஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி டைம் கன்ஸ்ட்ரெயின்ஸ், மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் த லீகல் ஃப்ரெட்டர்னிட்டி, ஃபேமிலி மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி எலெக்டட் மெம்பர்ஸ், மீடியா அண்ட் ப்ரெஸ், வெரி குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ அண்ட் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு பி ஹியர் ஆன் திஸ் அக்கேஷன். ஐ விஷ் த நியூலி எலெக்டட் சேர்மன் மிஸ்டர் அமல்ராஜ், வைஸ் சேர்மன் கார்த்திகேயன், மிஸ்டர் எஸ் பிரபாகரன் மெம்பர் பார் கவுன்சில் ஆஃப் இந்தியா அண்ட் கோ சேர்மன், நியூலி எலெக்டட் பார் கவுன்சில் மெம்பர்ஸ், ஐ எம் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு பி ஹியர் பிகாஸ் எவ்ரிபடி வாஸ் மென்ஷனிங் தட் திஸ் இஸ் தி ஃபஸ்ட் ஆஃப் இட்ஸ் கைண்ட் இன் த ஹோல் ஆஃப் தி கண்ட்ரி அண்ட் ஐ எம் வெரி ப்ரவுட் டு பி அ பார்ட் ஆஃப் திஸ் யூனிக் அக்கேஷன். I am very happy that you have invited me because whenever you have this function, you will be saying that this was firstly in 2019, you will be mentioning my name. I am very happy to be a part of this unique occasion. Just now, Advocate General was mentioning that as to how they have been disposing of all these complaints, pending complaints. And he has also been mentioning about all the good work they have done. I wish and hope that you will continue to do what the work that has been done by Mr. Singarvelan and Mr. Chandrasekhar and the Advocate General. I wish and hope that you will continue to do good work and carry forward the work that has been done by them. The legal profession, no, it's a very noble profession. Most of the worldly personalities hail from the legal profession. Because of the time constraint, I am not mentioning about the names, but to mention about the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, and so many other people, no, they all hail from this great profession. Once you enter the profession, you need to have a feeling that you have entered here only to render some kind of service, not merely know how much fees that you are getting. It's a kind of service to the humanity. So the members of the, now the elected members, chairman, vice chairman, all of you know you are representing this great profession. Onerous responsibilities are cast upon you. All the members, look at the members, all of them, many of them I saw going with the bouquets and going with the shawl and all of them look at you, look upon you. All of you know that they always look upon you for each and everything. I wish that you must excel well, both in your professional and personal ethics. I'm told that by my brothers, and also when I was in Delhi also, I was hearing that you had so many obstacles in coming to this profession, in coming to this position. Obstacles are nothing but stepping stones for doing more and more work. Whenever you do something, no, you think of the obstacle that you got. Use those obstacles as a stepping stone. And as the Prabhakaran said, make your flag higher, fly higher and higher, and to the highest in the entire country. I wish and hope that you would do the work for the welfare of the lawyers across the state. Family members எல்லாம் வந்திருக்கிறீங்க, நிறைய தொழில் வரும், நிறைய பணம் வரும்னு நினச்சிக்காதீங்க. இதில் எல்லாம் எலெக்ட் ஆனதுனால ஒன்றும் இல்லை, பொறுப்பு தான் எல்லாம் நிறைய பேர் வந்திருக்கீங்க, சந்தோஷமாக சிரிச்சிட்ருக்கீங்க, பொறுப்பு தான். நிறைய ஒன்றும் ஒர்க் வராது, நிறைய பணம் வரும்னு நினச்சிக்காதீங்க. எல்லோரும் சந்தோஷமாக வந்திருக்கிறீங்க. இட்ஸ் அ மோர் ஆஃப் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி தென் ஆஃப் நோ ஜஸ்ட் எக்ஸலிங் இன் த ப்ரொஃபஷன். மோர் ஆஃப் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஆஸ் அ லீடர்ஷிப் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி டு டூ சம் குட் ஒர்க் ஃபார் த என்டையர் லீகல் ப்ரொஃபஷன். இதை கடைசியாக பேசுறது ரொம்ப கஷ்டம். நான் ஏதோ நாலு வார்த்தை சொல்லலாம்னு நினச்சேன். ரைட் ஃப்ரம் அட்வொகேட் ஜென்ரல் அப் டு பிரபாகரன், வாட் எவர் ஐ வாண்டட் டு சே எவ்ரிபடி ஹஸ் செட். சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட்டில் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, ஒரு கோர்ட்டில் வந்து எல்லா கோர்ட்டிலும் மோரர்லெஸ் உங்களுக்கு எல்லாருக்கும் தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும், ஒரு பெஞ்சில் வந்து ரெண்டு ஜட்ஜஸ் இருப்பாங்க. ஒரு ஜட்ஜ் வந்து ஜட்ஜ்மெண்ட் எழுதுகிற ஜட்ஜ் வந்து அனுப்பிச்சி வைப்பாங்க இன்னொருத்தருக்கு, நான் ஐ எம் சென்டிங் இயர் வித் மை ஜட்ஜ்மெண்ட்டு ஃபார் யுவர் அப்ரூவல்னு சொல்லிட்டு. அந்த இன்னொரு ஜட்ஜ் வந்து என்ன பண்ணுவாங்க, ஒன்றும் எழுத மாட்டாங்க, எக்ஸப்டிங் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு ஆட் சம்திங். they will say, I respectfully agree the judgment which you have proposed by your lordship or by your by the judge. So I respectfully agree whatever has been said from Justice, from Advocate General up to Mr. Prabhakaran. I respectfully agree whatever has been said. I only want to add only few things that, no, just that comes across my mind. I only differ from few aspects what Brother Justice Kirubhakaran has said. Traffic violation, suspend. Helmet, suspend. This, suspend. Take action. This, no, I beg to differ. I beg to differ from Justice Kirubhakaran. Why? Because no, an advocate can be proceeded against for misconduct only if he is found guilty of misconduct under Section 35 of the Advocates Act. Section 35 of the Advocates Act provides that all cases of professional or other misconduct. Misconduct is not defined, but you know, what has been construed by the particular committee, it is called misconduct, shall be disposed of by the disciplinary committee of the State Bar Council concerned. But before a State Bar Council sends the complaint to the committee, the Bar Council has to be satisfied that there has been a prima facie case irukudan solitte neenga paakanum. So what I would suggest is, before ever you just send it to the committee, better you examine it whether there is a prima facie case. Why I am saying this is a very great responsibility to find out whether there is a prima facie case or not. This I am saying, as many of the speakers have said, number of law colleges are more, number of entrants to the profession is more. And many of them are first-generation lawyers. Mr. Prabhakaran was saying about the many persons entering the profession from the rural areas also. I'm saying that many of them are first-generation lawyers, not much of exposure to the profession, not much of exposure to the advocacy, not much of exposure to the etiquettes. இப்போ போய் கோர்ட்டில் உட்காருவார், ஒருத்தர் முன்னு முன்னு ஏதோ பேசுவார், உடனே மேஜிஸ்ட்ரேட்டு கோபம் வந்துடும், எழுது ஒரு கம்ப்ளைண்ட்டு இவர் மேலே, இவ உட்காந்து கோர்ட்டில் வந்து முன்னு முணுத்துட்டுருக்கிறாரு, இல்லைன்னா என் மேலே பெட்டிஷன் அனுப்புகிறாரு. சம்திங் நோ, சம்படி வில் சென்ட் சம் பெட்டிஷன்ஸ் நோ தோ டு த பார் கவுன்சில். ஸோ இஸ் அ ஃபஸ்ட் ஜென்ரேஷன் லாயர். இஃப் யூ டேக் வெரி ஸ்ட்ரிஞ்சன்ட் ஆக்ஷன் எகேன்ஸ்ட் ஹிம், தட் லாயர் ஹூ ஹஸ் டேக்கன் த ப்ரொஃபஷன் இஸ் டோட்டலி ரூயின்டு. அவர் ப்ரொஃபஷன் ஃபுல்லாக இஸ் ரூயின்டு. If you take action, ruined, avladha adukapram vanda avanga wife vande unne vakilukku appiye ponnu thara maatren sonnanga munna kattikitte na indha mari kashtapettu irukren, she will go away. If his life, I know an advocate from my place, I know, I don't want to mention his name, he remained unmarried, he went for searching for some bride, they did not ponnu thara maatren solittanga, then no, some one thing or other, somewhere or other, no, he got into problem, some disciplinary proceeding by the bar council, then his life was totally ruined. He left the profession, oorla poi vivasayam pannittu irukkar, I do not know whether he is alive or dead now, because he was no addicted to some bad habits also. This, no, I am mentioning it, only take stringent action only in case of a defiant, persistent, இது மாதிரி தான் பண்ணிகிட்டே இருப்பார் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி சொன்னாக்க, தென் யூ டேக் ஆக்ஷன். அதர்வைஸ் நோ, கால் தம், ஷோ த ஸ்டிக், ஐ ஹாவ் எ ஸ்டிக் வித் மீ. இஃப் யூ ப்ரொசீட் லைக் திஸ், ஜஸ்ட் எ வார்னிங், ஜஸ்ட் எ சென்ஷர், ஜஸ்ட் கால் இம் டு த கமிட்டி, ஜஸ்ட் எ வார்னிங், ஜஸ்ட் எ சென்ஷர். திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட், ஐ வாண்ட் டு சே திஸ், எ ஸ்டிச் இன்ஸ் டைம், ஏற்ற காலத்தில் போடப்பட்ட தையல். திஸ் வில் சேவ் தி ஃபியூச்சர் ஆஃப் தட் பர்டிகுலர் லாயர், save the family members, everything will be saved, and that stitch in time he will remember throughout his service, throughout his professional career. So this, no, I just want to have you know, just like our grandfather will show stick, idha parun adike poram par, he will never beat. So just like that, no, please adopt that attitude. This will pave the way for the concerned advocate to mend his conduct in future, and this would also encourage the lawyers to perform better in the profession. I know many lawyers who have become successful, they have faced some disciplinary proceedings. If you ask them why he became successful, he said that this person has sent a petition against me, therefore I took that as a challenge, and then I made a resolution to come up higher up in the profession. Had there been a very stringent action against that particular advocate, he would not have shown up to that position. So this, all these things, no, don't think that I am just imagining something. all these things, because all of you know that I hail from Mafisal, as Brother Kribakaran was saying, that I initially started my practice in Tirupattur, where my senior was there. Thereafter, I went to Krishnagiri. Then thereafter, a new municipal court was started in Arur. I shifted there. So all this I am saying, no, from out of my own experience, which I have seen, which I have witnessed. This is the thing, no, that I just wanted to mention to the any harsh punishment may be necessary only if the misconduct is, you know, very persistent defiance, or where it affects the administration of justice, where it affects the rendering of justice in the court, or where is I know some one or two people, no, from Gujarat, I think, there's advocate. He kept on sending petitions. Whomsoever is the judicial officer comes, he will keep on sending petitions. So what the judicial officers, they wrote a petition to the Registrar General himself. To the Registrar General, please take action against this. Please write about him to the, this is from Gujarat. Please write about him to the Bar Council, because no, we are not in a position to work. Then no, the Registrar General wrote, one word from Registrar General closed. Correct. One word of love, then the Registrar General wrote, this person, no, he was suspended. He came with the tears. He came in tears. Why I am saying is, once a disciplinary action is taken and once a lawyer is suspended, his lifeline is gone. His oxygen is gone. You must come and see his face in the court. He never looked like a lawyer. Never looked like a lawyer, because so long as you are a lawyer, okay, everything is perfect. The once that it is suspended, the moment, you know, your lifeline is gone. This, you know, I am saying this because while I am saying, I am requesting the Bar Council members to be lenient, not to be very stringent. At the same time, I insist upon all the lawyers to realize your responsibility, because the professional conduct and etiquette prescribed by the Bar Council of India in Chapter 2, I request all of you to go through it, Part 6 of the Bar Council of India rules. A lawyer is a lawyer not only in the court, but he is also a lawyer both in the public as well as in the private life. You should benchmark yourself against the best. Many lawyers are here from the Mufisal, whomsoever you think, for example, our Advocate General, you will keep him all the time, only modulated voice. Voice will never go up, voice will never come down. Same, when I was sitting in the Madras High Court, I used to wonder how he is having such a very nice modulated voice. Very, very nice modulated voice. Many of you would not have had occasion to hear him. So it's like that, no, you should benchmark yourself against the best. This Advocate General, I am just pointing it out. So there are innumerable duties and responsibilities of the advocates. You will not emulate somebody the best in your district. Justice Subramani was just now referring to about that book. I also had the occasion. I also keep that book with me. I endorse the views of Justice Subramani. I request the Bar Council, no, to publish it, because it gives all the duties and responsibilities, duty to your client, duty to the court, due to the public, due to your colleagues, everything, you know, it is given, and it's a very conservative and very traditional ideas and thinking is there. I request the Bar Council, you know, to publish it. In fact, when I was having this book, when I was showing it in Ranchi in one occasion, at that time Abhishek Manisingh, the senior advocate, he was also requesting all the Bar Council members, no, to bring this a new publication, because it is out of print. Such a treasure, no, we have in Madras. Very good treasures we have in Madras. I request all the advocates to keep up this treasure. Though I am saying that there are many duties and responsibilities, I would like to highlight only one or two of them, not much, and I will not take much of your time. Everybody is already showing their shawls because they want to go and felicitate their elected members. I'll just take a couple of minutes. We have a great duty towards the client. You are in a very, the relationship with the client is like a trust, no, between you and him. At times what they do is, one or two examples only I will give. At times what they do is, they give just like that, no, any admissions they give in the court. On behalf of my client, I am just, you know, giving this concurrence. Without taking exact concurrence, actual concurrence from your client, no, please don't give such kind of admissions. I recall one matter. where the advocate is a government advocate, he said that, okay, you appoint is a government advocate on behalf of, is from Kerala, on behalf of the government of Kerala, I just give my concurrence for referring the matter to arbitration. Referring the matter to arbitration is very serious, is it not? Because it takes away the main matter from the mainstream of civil courts to the another forum, another to the arbitration. So for that, he should have taken consent from the concerned higher official. Higher official, he should have taken written consent. Without that, he had given the consent. This has got very serious repercussion when the matter came up under section, after the, against the appeal under section 37, when it came before the, when it came, not under 37, they challenged the very reference itself. When it came before us, we set it aside on the ground that the advocate has not taken the concurrence of the government official for referring the matter to arbitration. And also, no, the advocate is not to identify with the cause of the client itself. An advocate should always remember that he is an officer of the court. Before ever he goes to the client, his first duty is only to the court. And many a time we get many matters where all of you know that no, the advocate is not to engage in any trade or profession or any other profession other than the legal profession. We get many matters throughout the country. Of course, fortunately, we did not have even one matter from Tamil Nadu. Because no, here probably everybody wants to focus only on the legal profession. They are not interested in others. Once they enter profession, they only focus on the legal profession. Number of cases are brought before us where the advocate is carrying on additional business. In particular, one or two matters we got where they are carrying on the business in the chamber itself. Fortunately, that advocate was caught because he printed the visiting card itself for the other profession as the chamber itself. Of course, in this case, because he tendered apology, we said that no, we just let him go off. In 2003, 6 SSC 186, a concerned advocate was charged for running an STD booth. STD booth. He can't run an STD booth in addition to the legal profession. The court has admonished him and let him away because he was a handicapped advocate. So these are all the few instances, no, where an advocate has to be very careful in following your professional etiquettes and the rules prescribed under the conduct prescribed under the Advocates Act. Many of my previous speakers have spoken about the competence in the profession. Now many matters are commercial matters are coming from all over our state also. In fact, as against the appeal under section 37, we got some two or three appeals from Coimbatore and from Tuticorin. You will not believe. They are the matters arising out of arbitration. This I am pointing it out because with the emergence of globalization and explosion of knowledge and technology, continuing legal education is necessary. Commercial litigation, don't think that commercial litigation is only meant for the high court or for some cities like Coimbatore or something like that. Commercial litigations everywhere is emerging. With foreign direct investments coming everywhere, we are getting all kinds of commercial litigation from all the official places also. So lawyers should become more competent in all the spheres. I wish and hope that as per section 6(1)(ee), please make a note, Bar Council members, section 6(1)(ee) of the Advocates Act, it is incumbent upon the respective state bar councils to conduct seminars, organize speeches on legal topics by eminent jurists and publish journals and papers of legal interest. You should endeavor to organize such programs for such continuing legal education to raise the standards of the legal profession in the state of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. This mere organization of mere this unorganized programs here and there, once in 2 months or once in 3 months, this may not be enough. This may not be continuous. This may not be adequate. Elected member Balu was saying that the newly elected members are planning to bring out some large journals for the Bar Council. I wish that you bring it out at the earliest. Additionally, I would like to suggest that like in Kerala, you should also have an academy. academy for the advocates, because counseling the clients, oratory skills, arguments, and also preparing of the draftings, and somebody was saying about the spoken English, advocacy skills, fact gathering and articulation skills, time and stress management skills, etiquettes to be followed in the court. All these things are not learnt by 1 or 2 days. This needs lot of observation, practice, constant practice. Additionally, this can be stimulated by kind of guided theoretical training program, which is to be inculcated for the lawyers. For this, you need some kind of academy where you can train the lawyers, in particularly young members. The Advocate General is also there. I request the Advocate General to bring an academy on par with the state of Kerala. I request you to talk to the government of Tamil Nadu to make some huge contribution for this, because individually they cannot do. They might have already spent a lot of money for being elected, so they may not have much of, not the other thing I am saying, traveling and others. So they may not have the resource and the skills. And even if they open it also, it requires lot of resources, finance, and so many things are required, and the faculties, so many things are required to keep these programs running. So I request the Advocate General to talk to the government of Tamil Nadu, because I am told that the welfare fund is also enhanced to 7 lakhs and odd. I wish that I request the Advocate General to just get some huge contribution for this innovative idea of having the academy. I also request the bar members to approach the senior advocates. Let us make a beginning. Let us make a beginning. When Kerala is able to do, why not Tamil Nadu? No, why not Tamil Nadu? And everybody was saying that the Tamil Nadu state Bar Council has got very rich potential and very high resources. We can just further improve it and make the state of Bar Council of state of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry the first one in the country to have such kind of continuing training program for the lawyers. Though there are many number of entrants, don't get disappointed, because there are many avenues now open. When we all entered profession, only legal profession, only you can become a lawyer and then attached to some office and then carry on the profession. Now there are so many avenues. Because of the time constraints, I am not mentioning. I will reserve all those things for any other program, which I expect sooner you invite me for inauguration of the academy at the sooner. This is the request that I am putting to the members of the chairman, Bar Council chairman Amal Raj and others. When they came to invite me itself, I told this is what I am going to talk. We will meet at that time. I will come with more ideas at that time. Once again, I wish the chairman, vice chairman and other elected members for your successful tenure in the office. Your dedication and devotion in enhancing the welfare and the professional competence of the lawyers in the state of Tamil Nadu would certainly enable the lawyers to have quality and sustained performance in the profession, thereby making valuable contribution in the administration of justice. I thank the Prabhakaran and the chairman and the vice chairman and other elected members for sharing some of my thoughts and be with you and sharing my happy moments. Thank you very much.